Hi, I'm Tarek. Thanks for visiting the Crouzet Tech Lab. In this video, together we will program the new Syr-line front panel digital timer that we reviewed in the first video of this series and installed in the second video. First, let's talk about the screen indicators. T1 and T2 turn on only in running mode and show the current running time. PROG, or program, will be seen when the user is in programming mode. Lock is illuminated if the optional lock function is used. Settings cannot be changed in run mode when lock is illuminated. IN, input, and RST, reset, will be lit when electrical input or reset are being detected. FNCT, or function, will show when the program time section shows the current running function. Out will turn on when the relay is on for single output configurations, and 1 and 2 will turn on in double relay configurations depending on the relay. Next, let's enter basic programming mode. In this mode, we can program the main options found in a digital timer. To enter programming mode, we press the second and fourth keys at the same time and hold for 3 seconds. You will then see the main menu. The second key moves between programming options, basic, advanced, and test. We will select basic and then use the fourth key to enter our selection. In basic mode, we can change function, time range, and count style. In some versions, like the one I'm using, we can also select memory option and output 2 style. Today, we will change the function. Let's use function D as an example, also called flasher or symmetrical repeat cycle. To select function D, we use the third key until we see function D, and then we save the selection by selecting the fourth key. A complete list of available functions can be seen on the data sheet shown in the description box below. Now let's change the time range to seconds, then press save. Now we select countdown and again press save. Let's use the memory function so the time we select will be saved if there is a power outage. Finally, in our last programming step, we will select the second output as instantaneous, which means the second relay will turn on at the same time as the power supply. Then press save. Let's exit the programming menus. All we need to do is press the first key twice. This time delay relay has a number of advanced programming functions you can use to get the most out of your timer. To enter advanced programming mode, you press the second and fourth keys at the same time and hold for 3 seconds. You will then see the main menu. You will select advanced. First, we have the option to select the input type PNP or NPN. Today, we will select PNP and then press save. Let's imagine, for instance, we want to make sure that users cannot enter a time limit greater than 3 seconds. Here we demonstrate setting the time limit to a maximum of 3 seconds. So we press the third key to change the timing and the second key to move between digits. Once we're finished, we press save. You can save power and extend the life of the LCD screen by reducing brightness. Also, this can be handy in applications that are very dark. You can see how you can toggle between 100% screen brightness, but for good viewing, in this video we left the brightness at 100%. Another way to save power and extend the LCD life is a sleep after function. Here we choose 10 seconds so the LCD will turn off after 10 seconds. The relay is still fully functioning, the screen is simply turned off. You can press any button to turn the screen back on. Next, let's create a password to set the lock functions. Level 1 locks programming, while Level 2 locks programming and the selected timing to prevent unauthorized or accidental changes to the selected time. We will select Level 2 and press the fourth key. Here's how to select the 4-digit password. We will use 1111 as our password, remembering that the third key changes the numeric value while the second key allows you to move between each number. Once the password is set, we press the fourth key to save the password. Finally, if you want to start over with the default factory settings, there is also a default settings option. We're done. We went back to the main menu. We see that we can only change timing with the password we selected. We also see that we cannot set the timing to more than 3 seconds. Let's go to the main menu again by pressing the second and fourth keys at the same time, holding for 3 seconds, and selecting test mode. In this mode, you can test inputs and outputs, the screen setting, and the memory settings to make sure everything is working as you intended. We can turn the output relay on and off, out 1, with the third key. With double output versions, like the one we're reviewing together, we can also test out 2 with the third key. Let's check display and press the third key to see that all LEDs turn on and are working correctly. We can press any key to return. Finally, the memory option lets us know that the timer's internal memory is working fine. We test it by pressing the third key and confirming with the fourth key. And remember, at any time in test mode, we can send an input or reset signal. If the light turns on when expected, we're assured that there are no wiring problems.
I hope you enjoyed working with me during the 3-part video series, where we discuss the features, installation, and programming of the Crouzet Syr-line family of front panel digital timers. If you have any questions, would like to know price or availability, see the description box below for handy links. Please share with us your feedback and any comments you have, and consider liking this video and subscribing to our YouTube channel. Thanks for visiting us at the Crouzet Tech Lab. Until next time.